Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over a few ways to extract data from hyperlinks in Excel. So first we will show you how to get the data in column A that acts like a hyperlink, but you can't really see the HTTP or the HTTPS address. So where is that link actually going? And the second set of options we're going to show you is how to use a few different VBA modules to be able to extract the hyperlink from the formatted hyperlink here in column A. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that. So the first method we're going to show you is the very simple manual process of copying and pasting a link. So if I'm in Excel, and I just click on a hyperlink, my browser will automatically be opened to the link that hyperlink is pointing to. And I can see up here in my address bar that this is the actual hyperlink. So if I highlight that address and right click and go to copy, and then I alt tab back to Excel, and I can right click and just click paste, and the link will be copied into B2. So I now know that this is the actual link that A2 is pointing to. And also, if I hover over A2, you can see the link will show up in this tag right here. And I can see that that link does match the one that I pasted into B2.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
Sometimes in Excel, there is a hard-coded link right here. But when you go to click in the cell, it takes you automatically to that link in your browser. But what if you just want to copy the text of this link without activating the link? Well, if I click in the cell above it and I just use my down arrow instead of clicking on that cell, the link will not be activated. And then I can go up here in the formula bar and I can highlight the entire link and right click and go to copy. And now if I were to click in another cell, I can right click and go to paste. And you can see the difference here. The top one was formatted as an actual link, but the one down here is not formatted as a link and it's not in blue. So if I actually click out of here and click on B3, because of the way I pasted this text into B3, I am not being taken to the link. But I can tell if I hover over B2, again down here on the right in the tag, I can see the link that this is pointing to, and I can tell that this is an active link if I click on it. A third option I have for a link inside Microsoft Excel is if I know there is an active link, and instead of left-clicking on the cell, I right-click, I can go down here to this option that says Edit Hyperlink. And there's a few things in here to note. First of all, Microsoft Office 365 right up here, this is the text that I'm displaying right here in A3. So while I'm displaying that text, there's actually a link. And down here in the address field is where I will be taken if I click on this link. So I can remove that link if I don't want the hyperlink in there anymore. Or I can highlight this link here and right click and go to copy. And I'm going to click cancel. And then if I go into B3 and right click and go to paste, I can see that I have pasted the link that's actually activated when I click on cell A3. But let's say I have a link and I don't want it to be activated when I click on it. If I right click in B2, I can go down to Edit Hyperlink, and right here is a button that says Remove Link. If I click on that, I can now click into cell B2 and not activate the hyperlink automatically. I can also right click on a hyperlink cell and go to Edit Hyperlink. And I can actually edit the address here so that this hyperlink goes to a different web page. But what if I have a big list of hyperlink cells in Excel and I want to get all of the links out of those hyperlink cells? Sort of displayed like this. Here's the link in A2, and here's where the link is actually going in B2. I'm going to delete those for now, and then show you how to use Visual Basic to be able to extract these links. So if I hit Alt F11, I will be taken to the Visual Basic window. So if I go up to Insert and go here to Module, I can insert some VBA code that I will be able to use in Excel. So if you go out to our blog and you scroll a little more than halfway down, you can see the code that I'm about to paste right here into Visual Basic for Applications. I will include the link to our blog entry below in the description on YouTube. So if I go back to VBA and I right click and I click paste, here is the URL function that I have copied from our blog. And note that the function here is called URL, and it's a range argument, which means that's a cell inside of Microsoft Excel. So now if I go back to Excel and I type equals, I now have a function called URL because I've created it in Visual Basic for Applications. So if I put a left parenthesis, I need to send in that range. Where is the cell where I want to get the URL from? And in this case, it's going to be A2. So I'm going to close my parentheses and hit enter. And I can see that I'm getting this link back. And if I highlight over my Excel online, I can see in the tag that it is www.myexcelonline.com/category/formulas. So I did in fact get the link from here. So I can just use equals URL again with a left parenthesis. And this time I can do A3. And again, URL with a left parenthesis. And I can use A4. And if I hover over Google, I can see this is www.google.com. And this one is www.microsoft.com, etc. Also on our blog, a little bit above the code that I just copied, there's a subroutine called extract HL that I'm going to highlight and copy. And then I'm going to alt tab back to my module window in VBA, hit enter a few times, and right click and hit paste. If when you copied this, these question marks automatically appear, just backspace and get rid of them on each line. And note that this subroutine is called extract HL. So if I alt tab back to Excel and I go up to view, macros, view macros, I have the extract HL right here. So I'm going to click run, and I can see now that this subroutine went through everywhere I have a hyperlink cell, and it displayed the actual address of the URL over here in column B. So hopefully that gives you a few different ways that you can get the URL from a hyperlink formatted cell in Microsoft Excel. If you would like further explanation on any of these methods, please visit our blog in the link below in the description on YouTube. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.